I meant to get you guys to count down, and I got distracted. I apologize. Amen. So who's here today? Raise your hand if you're here. Okay, we got a few people here. Put your hands down. Stand to your feet if you're here. Uh-oh, we got some people still in the bed. Oh, man. Okay, have a seat. Oh! That was a good try. Okay, y'all be seated. All right. Oh! Hands in the air. Let's pray to our Father God. Say, Father God, thank you so much for this day and for your word. Thank you for you. Thank you for your Holy Spirit who lives in me, helps me, comforts me, helps me. Helps me is important. Thank you so much, God. I'm here and listening, speaking to me. Speak to me. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, y'all can be seated. First, I want to welcome everybody here. You guys really do look alert, even if you're a little slow getting up sometimes. You look alert, which is good. And I also want to welcome our online visitors, those people who are looking from their homes, wherever they are, in their PJs or whatever. We just welcome you, and we want to say welcome to Faith Landmarks Ministries. I have some announcements, so if I go down before I make my announcements, please say, do like this. What does that say? What? So just remind me, just in case. Okay, so we have some expectations in KidzTown. And I need one person to tell me, I thought I had three people. I have one, two, and three. I thought I had three. Okay, give me one of the expectations. Yes. Respect your neighbor and keep your hands and feet to yourself. Two. Stay in your seat and raise your hand to speak. Good. Good so far. Go ahead. Wow. And he changed it into language that everybody understands. He said, don't speak while the teacher is speaking. In other words, remain quiet while the teacher is talking. So who is the teacher? Right now, it's me. Soon it's going to be. Sometimes it's. And sometimes it's one of you. Amen. So whoever is in front at that time on the mic, that's the person you're paying attention to. Okay? Or it could be Miss Denise or Miss Infinity. It could be anybody. Okay? Who is here to be sure that you are safe and worshiping and learning the things of God. So God can just bring you up into what he created you to be. Amen. All right. Let me see. I am looking at some announcements. Did everybody get one of these? Okay. What's it about? It's about water baptism. Okay. And water baptism, I think, Mr. Scott, you're going to tell a little bit about that later? Okay. It's going to be happening next week. And read this. Talk to your parents about it. If you have not been baptized since you've been saved, since you asked Jesus in your heart, have you been baptized? And you can find out what to do. Amen. And then we have, something exciting. How many people are in the Royal Rangers or Impact Girls in here? Oh, fun, huh? It's good? Well, it will be. This paper tells about Royal Rangers Impact Girls, and it's starting up this Wednesday for a whole new year. Now, in the service, there were three people here and one absent who were being presented as star impact girls, okay? So don't forget this, talk it over with your parents, and I have one thing that's not out yet. This is about camp meeting. Now in camp meeting, the adults always say, "Wah!" You know, go crazy like that. But it's not going crazy, it's just being excited because KidzTown has a camp meeting all itself. And it's called Expedition. Expedition. And it's gonna be held the same time that the adult camp meeting is being held. So you can be in KidzTown and be in on the exciting expedition, tracking the footsteps of Paul. These will be given out next week. Mr. Scott said there's so much stuff to give out this week. We're gonna give these out next week. But it gives you time because it's in October, okay? And you can always invite other people. Now we're gonna be receiving the offering. So if I offer you something, what is that? If I offer you something, what am I doing? Man, you guys, I'm not doing a good job, or you guys are expecting the teacher to be walking to a seat. If I offer you something, Infinity, what am I giving you? I'm giving you something, right? I'm giving you something. And when you offer God something, you're giving God something that belongs to you. If you're tithing, you're giving God something that belongs to Him. You're giving it back. You're giving Him what already belongs to Him. So if you don't give it to Him, that means you are taking it from Him, robbing Him or stealing from Him. So we return the tithe and we give from our hearts whatever you want to give, okay? So a tithe is 10% and an offering is anything over 10% of what you have coming into you. If you have birthday money, anybody had a birthday recently? Okay, and if you get money for your birthday, sometimes people give you money, sometimes they give you gifts. If you got $10, how much is a tithe? 10%. Let me see how many people know from their math. 10%. I'm looking for $1. If you got $5, how much is a tithe? 50 cents. If you got a penny, how much is a tithe? It's a penny, because you can't split a penny into 10 little parts. You can't split it up. But if you got a dime, how much is a tithe? I'm trying to find somebody who hasn't already answered because they're math. A penny, amen. So hold your tithe or your offering or both up. I feel like y'all need to stand up. Stand up. Now, do we have somebody who wants to pray over the offering? Okay, hold it up. Close your eyes. You close your eyes just to block out. God can hear you with your eyes open, but you're gonna be looking around. But if you close your eyes, you focus on Him, okay? Only reason I don't close my eyes right now is that I have to look at you guys. I'm supposed to keep my eyes open. But when I'm out there, buddy, I'm closing my eyes and focusing on God. Say, Father God, here's my tithe on my offering. I give it because you said to do it, and I give it with joy. Use this money. How come I only hear my voice? Use this money for your purpose, build your kingdom with it, and return it to me so that I can give again and again, and again, and again, and again, 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 again. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, when the music starts, you can put your offering or tithe into the buckets that's over there.
This is a new day. Everything bursting.
Good morning, everyone. Go ahead and stand to your feet. We're so excited to be here and worship with y'all, and let's go ahead and get started.
Speaking about, okay, I forgot I had this on. What have we begun speaking about? different kinds of prayer. Good. I wasn't looking, so I wasn't going to be looking for your eyes to see if you were raising your hand or whatever. Okay. Different kinds of prayer. And we're going to do a little bit of review from last week. Yes, sir. Say that again. Oh, you were stretching. Amen. That's okay. I stretch sometimes too. Okay, so these are some kinds of prayer, and we've gone over some of them, but last week we went over, what? Anybody remember? Okay, let me look at my little sheet. This was our Bible verse. Would you show that one, please? 1 Corinthians 14:15. Praying with the Spirit, okay? Praying with the Spirit. What's another word for praying with the Spirit? Praying in other tongues, okay? So, how many of you received the baptism of the Holy Spirit last week? Anybody in here? Amen. All right, up on your feet. We got to wake you guys up because I know some of you. How many of you were here last week? Okay, I know we had some people here last week. Okay, we're going to do a quick running in place. Y'all ready? But we're just going to run to the count of 10 because we got a lot to go over today. Y'all ready? Let me see your eyes if you're ready. Put your hands up if you're ready. All right, if you're not ready, ready or not, here we come. Go! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop. Hands up. Touch your knees. Touch your head. Touch your shoulders. Touch your head. Touch your toes. Some of you were watching me to see what I was going to say. I was trying to trick you, but I couldn't trick you. Okay, y'all can have a seat. Stand up. Do a little shake. Shake, 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 shake. Okay, sit down. Okay, so we went over 1 Corinthians 14:15. I will pray with the Spirit, but I will also pray with my understanding. Praying with the Spirit is speaking in other tongues, and we pray with the Spirit so that we can, when we don't know what to pray. Do you always know what to pray? I don't. You can pray for other people when you don't know what to pray. You don't always know what's going on with them. I don't sometimes even know what's going on with me. But I can pray in the Spirit, and God allows me to pray in the Spirit, okay? And he hears what I say. So, what is praying in the Spirit? It's the next one. And praying in the Spirit, go ahead. Praying in the Spirit is not praying real hard, even though sometimes you might pray real hard. And it is not praying real quiet, even though sometimes you may pray real quiet. And it is not, well, it is allowing the Holy Spirit to direct your prayers. Sometimes you're hard, sometimes you're quiet or whatever. So let's do a little quick check. When you're praying in the Spirit, you don't pray in your language. If you speak English, you don't speak English. If you speak Spanish, you don't speak Spanish. If you speak something else, you don't speak something else. You don't speak Japanese or whatever, nothing that you can, that you can think about what you're saying. You just pray what God puts. He puts that prayer inside you and you speak it out with your mouth. Y'all ready? So I'm gonna do maybe about a 10-second praying in the Holy Ghost. Ready? Let's go. Stop. Notice you can stop. Start back up. Let's pray real hard in the spirit. Y'all ready? And like your coach voice. Y'all know what a coach voice is? It's like you're in the gym and the coach says, give me 10 push-ups. Okay. They don't say, give me 10 push-ups. You know what I mean? They say it loud. Y'all ready? Hard. Let's go. I only hear myself and I hear a couple of other people. If you pray in the spirit, pray in the spirit real hard. Go. Run up, stop. Moment of silence at school. Who has a moment of silence at school? Okay. You can pray in the spirit, but you have to pray real so the teacher doesn't say, what are you doing? You talking. So you say, go. Stop. Baby sleeping. Your mom said, don't you dare wake that baby up. But you need to pray in the spirit. You ready? Baby sleeping. Stop. Something is after you. You can feel fear coming on. You know you can feel it. But you should not have fear. You should have love, and you should be able to pray that thing away. Ready? Let's go. Stop. You can pray in the spirit. Pray for your parents. Y'all ready? Just in our normal voices, we're going to pray for your parents. Do you know what your parents need? You know a couple of things, but you don't know all of it, right? So let's pray for what they really need. God knows. Go. Stop. Who has a brother? Okay, we're going to pray for all the brothers. Ready? Go. Stop. Who has a sister? We're going to pray for all the sisters. Ready? Go. Okay. Now, you know what you want to be when you grow up, and sometimes you don't. But God knows what He created you to be. Let's pray about that future. Are y'all ready? About you. What God has planned for you. Let's pray it. You don't know everything that God has planned. He may have given you a little idea, but He could have you be a big evangelist. He could have you go on a mission field. He could have you be a missionary right in your home. Y'all ready? Let's pray for ourselves. Go. Stop. When you go home, as you go home, you can pray at any time. I was praying for you guys on the way to church. On the way to church. Okay, so let's look at the next one. 1 Corinthians 14:15 says, But I will also pray with my understanding. I will pray with my spirit. Okay? So your spirit is praying. And when you're praying with your understanding, you know what you're praying. Okay? Let's see. What else? Why should I pray in the spirit? Okay. So it charges up my spirit. I can pray for things I don't know about. I could pray for the future. Oh, man, we prayed about all of that, didn't we? It's all of the above, all of them. Go to the next one. The word edify means what? It means to build up. So you're building up your spirit. You're charging it up. You know how people charge up phones? You plug it in. So it builds up some power in there. And then when you pray in the Holy Ghost, it fills, it powers you up. It's just like that phone that people charge up and they get 100%. You get 100, you get 150, you get 200. Sometimes you go in there. I remember when I be going in school, I go in there and somebody say hi to me and I say, hi. Sometimes I scare them, but I didn't mean to scare them. But I be charged up because I pray in the Holy Ghost all the way to school. Sometimes in the classroom, when people are playing around, causing other people not to hear the word, I'll start praying. Because God is going to deal with you. Because he doesn't like it when you keep other people from hearing his word. Amen. Thank you for reminding me of that. Okay, so evidence of being Spirit-filled is, and I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, and I want everybody who knows the answer to answer. When you pray in the Spirit, the evidence is you pray in tongues, okay? So why do they say in tongues? Because it's a lot of languages. Sometimes you're praying in a language, but you don't know the language. Sometimes you're praying in somebody's real language, and sometimes you just, they call it, talk about it being in the language of angels or whatever, but God knows what you're saying. Amen. So we have a new Bible verse today, and it is Romans 8:26, and I'm going to get you to say it after me. Okay, so say Romans 8:26. Let's say Romans 8:26, and the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. Groanings too deep for words. Groanings, they're talking about speaking in the Spirit, okay? Sometimes you don't know it's too deep for words. You don't know what you're saying. But the word intercede is something that is new for us. Intercede. Does anybody know what intercede means? If I intercede between you and your sister, that means y'all are going at it. Something is going on between the two of you, and I'm going to intercede. It means, what am I doing? I'm coming in between you and fix it. I'm interceding. Well, the word intercede in the Bible means you standing in the gap. So when you pray for somebody, you're interceding, you are standing in the gap. A gap means an opening. Some people have gap teeth. It's true. They have a little space in between their teeth. Okay? Some people have a gap between the wall and the window, and it'll let in air, okay? There's gaps. But in this gap, we're talking about, let's say this is you, okay? It could be a girl, it could be a boy, it could be anybody. But you see, this person right here is not saved. This person is not saved. This person has a lot of problems. They don't want to get saved because they don't know why they need it, or they don't understand it. Okay? So, this person right here needs prayer, but he won't come to God. We got God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, right? He won't come to, she won't come to God, he won't come to God because they don't know they need God. Anybody know what deception is? Deception means they're being tricked. They're being fooled, okay? They're being tricked, and they don't know that they're being tricked because they're being tricked. Okay? Over here, baby. Go right over there. She'll show you where. Thank you so much. Amen. Okay, so when you're deceived, it means you don't know it, because you don't know, because somebody's tricking you and you think it's true. So somebody's told them that God's not real. Or somebody's told them God can't help. Or somebody told them that whatever they told them, but it's not true. So when you're interceding, you're substituting for that person. That person's not going to go to God and ask for help. So you ask for help. You ask God to take the blinders off of their eyes, take the trick out of their ears, so that they will understand. They can understand. You ask God for them. It's like you're a substitute. You ever had a substitute teacher? Okay, they're standing in the place of that other teacher. Teacher can't be there. They're standing in that place. And they're teaching in the place of that teacher because they're standing in the gap, in that little space. So here's this person. And they over here saying, I don't want to hear any of that, what you're saying. I don't want to hear any of that junk. That's just junk. And you're like, no, it's not junk. But they can't hear you because in their minds, they believe something else. So you ask God, you say, God, I know you are God the Father, you are God the Son, you're God the Holy Spirit. Now, Mr. Scott, I'm sorry, I'm not gonna get this thing done. But God the Father, you're praying, you're saying, remove whatever it is that's standing between them and understanding, remove it, take it away. So if you're getting ready to go and talk to somebody about God, you ask God to take away the blinders or whatever it is that's coming in between them and God, take it away so that they can hear you. They'll listen to you. When you're just talking to somebody, they're not listening. You're just saying words. You know what wasting your breath means? It means you just... Anybody ever see Charlie Brown? And sometimes they're looking at adults and the adults are saying, wah, wah, wah. Wah, wah, wah. Are they hearing what the adult is saying? No, because their minds are someplace else. You're asking God, you're interceding. You're saying, God, I'm standing right here. Help my friend. Help them to understand. Help them to listen. Help them to hear. Get the devil out of the way so that they will hear and they can get saved. Now, how many of you have a friend or a parent or a relative who won't listen to God? They don't know God. I know some people. And they don't want to hear it. So I stand there and say, oh God, remove whatever's in the way and help me, help them to listen, help them to hear it. So blinders off, you're on your own. You hear it, now it's up to you to say yes or no. Those people, they can't say they didn't understand it because God took out the junk. So they can understand what you're saying to them. So before you go and witness to somebody, you pray for them. You intercede. Get the devil off of their back so they can hear God. Amen? I see some people who are listening, taking it all in. I see some people who are thinking about somebody. And God's gonna do what he said he'll do. You do your part, intercede. And that way it gives this person the opportunity to hear and understand. Amen? All right, so
All right.
Let's have everybody stand to your feet. We're going to play a game where we are going to, we're going to intercede. So let's just summarize what Miss Kathy taught us, okay? So which one needed to know Jesus? Which one? This one or this one? Raise your hand if it was this one. Not this one. Was it this one? This one. All right. So blue pants needed to know Jesus. All right. So blue pants needed to know Jesus. And this one is doing what? What's this one doing? Praying, interceding. All right. So because this one has a relationship with God through the Holy Spirit, this one right here is going to pray and intercede for this one. Now, we're going to play a game, and let's see. Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. All right. So here's what we're going to do. Is there anybody that does not want to play? Because I'd love to have everybody play this game. Everybody want to play? Okay, everybody wants to play. All right. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to line up all of this side. I need one volunteer to come over to this side. Who wants to come over? Okay, can you come over on this side? And just stand right here for a minute, okay? All right, so I need everybody on this side except for you to go over to the white line in the back and line up on a straight line on the white line. So yes, Infinity, if you could line them up going this way, okay? And then all of you guys and girls on the white line on that side, and Miss Denise, if you could line them up going this way on the white line, side by side. Keep your masks on.
Side by side.
Yeah, wake him up. You okay, buddy?
Who's asleep?
You gonna play?
Oh, I must.
Okay, go line up. All right, but we gotta go a little bit closer together. Yeah, shoulder to shoulder, because actually, you know what? Wow, there's too many people. Let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's just do 6. So the first 6 stand up, the last 6 sit down. So the first 6 stand up and the last 6 sit down. There you go. All right. Good job. All right. So these guys have a seat. You guys can play next. All right. We're going to do it twice. All right. Everybody have over here, have a seat. All right. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. So now here's what we're going to do. We're going to call you guys the Christians, okay? Because the Christians who know Jesus are going to intercede. All right. They're going to intercede for someone that is not saved, all right? They're going to take their prayers and take the person and stand in the gap for that person, all right? And then you guys are not, you're going to be the unbelievers on this side, okay? So the unbelievers are blinded, the Bible says. They're blinded. They don't see Jesus. They're not listening. We're talking about Jesus, but they're not listening. We demonstrate who Jesus is. We love them, but they don't see that God loves them. They have blinders on. Who puts the blinders on? The devil. All right, we're going to talk more about that later, but this is a game we're going to play, and we're going to need you to intercede. The Christians, you're going to need to intercede and come and take this little girl right here. And so what we're going to do is I'm going to give you a number. So the first two are number one. See, 1, 1. All right, you're number one, you're number one. You're number two, you're number two. Say number two. Number two? Kelsey, got it? Okay. Triumph, number three? Number three. All right. Number what? Four. And four. All right. And number five, and number what? Five, all right, you got it. And number, master, six, and six. Six, six, all right, you're six, and master, you're six. So everybody got your number? All right, tell me what your number is. All right, everybody got your number. All right, so when I call your number, you have to run and grab the girl and take her back, All right, so the Christians are interceding, and you're going to take this representative of the child, your friend, you're going to take them to Jesus and pray for them. All right. Now, what you have to do is if you run, you grab the girl, you can have him have a seat on the other side over here. Thank you. So when I call your number, for example, if I say one, the two number ones are going to run. You're going to try and grab the girl first and run back to your base. Grab back to your line, all right? Now, if, let's say, you run up here and you grab the girl and you get the girl and you run back to your base, the other person has to try and tag you, all right? Everybody understand? You have to try and tag the other person. If you tag the other person, then you win. So the person who tags you wins. And your team gets a point. All right. If you make it all the way back to your base without getting tagged, then your team gets a point. All right. Are you ready? All right. I'm going to go with number one. Go. Number one. Run, 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 run. Run, 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 run. All right. Go, 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 go. Got a tagger. Got a tagger. Okay. All right. Very good. Woo! All right, so we won. All right, you can give her back to me. There you go. Oh! She smashed. Okay. Are you ready? All right, we're going number six. Number six. Number six. Run, 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 run. Number six. Okay. Wow, he is super fast. All right, here you go. Thank you very much. All right, we got one and one. All right, let's go with number three. Number three, number three. Go, go, go. Tag him, tag him, tag him. All right, you got tagged. All right. Very good. All right. So we got two and one. All right, number four. Number four, number four. Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Don't get tagged. Don't get tagged. Okay. All right. All right, very good. Wow. Whew. All right. Number five. Number five. Number five. Number five. Go, go, go. Don't get tagged. Go, 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 go. All right. Miss Kathy, what's the score? Four and one. All right. Woo. Let's see. All right. Number two. Number two. Number two. Go, two, go. Go tagger, 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 go! Okay, barely made it. All right, Kelsey, good job. All right, all right. Four and two. All right, number three, number three. Whoa, what happened? Tag him, tag him, tag him. Oh, he bites the dust. That's okay. Good job, man. Good hustle. Love it, love it. Love the hustle. All right, number one, number one, number one, number one, number one. Okay, oh, 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 tagger, tagger, tagger. Oh, she got tagged. I think she got tagged. Did she get, okay. Good hustle, good hustle. All right, did everybody get a chance to run that's standing up? Okay, all right, so who won, Miss Kathy? The believers won. Okay, all right, you six and six, go have a seat. And switch places. Say again? Yes. Yes, definitely. All right. And yeah, bring them down closer. One, two, three, four, five, six. And Master, you want to play again, Master? Can you play again, Master? Come on up here. All right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Yes. All right. So let's do it. Number one, right? One and one. All right, number two. Two and two. Number three, Levi's. And three in the red shirt. And four. Four. And five with the black shirt, right? All right, bestie. Number five, one, two, three, four, five. Yeah, that's you. All right, number five. All right, now number six in the jacket. Number six, who's not paying attention over here in the black shirt. Yeah, that's you. And number seven, you new man that just walked in, and Master. Okay, are you ready? We have believers over here. And we have unbelievers over here, and you're going to intercede and come and grab her and take her to in prayer to the Lord. All right, number seven, run. Number seven. Number seven, number seven. And woo, all right. Number seven, good job, good hustle. All right, let's go, let's go, let's go. Number two, number two, number two. Number two, wow, she's fast, but he is faster. All right, good job. Good job, thank you now. All right, number one, number one, number one. Whoa, who's gonna get it? Oh, and there's a crash. Here you go, thank you. Good job. All right, number three, number three. Wow, number three lost a flip-flop. Oh, he's gonna tag him, tag him, tag him, tag him. Oh, if only for a flip-flop, okay. All right, what's the score, Miss Kathy?
3-1.
3-1, okay. All right, number two. Number two. Number two. Oh, she forgot to tag him. All right, here you go. All right, hold on. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, all right, all right. Five, number five, number five. Oh, wow, that was quick. All right, here you go, buddy. All right. Number four, number four, number four. Woo, he's got the afterburners on. There is no catching him. Whoa, he was ready to win. All right. All right. Okay, okay, number six. And boom, boom, she's tagged. Okay, here we go. All right. All right, everybody, back to your seat. Who won? The believers. All right, go back to your seat, everybody. All right. Did y'all enjoy that game? Yes. Okay. All right.
Amen. Hey, everybody.
Wait a minute.
Guess where I'm going? Guess where I'm going?
Where are you going, Goober?
You gotta guess. You gotta guess. Come on. Come
well,
on. Guess.
Class, where is he going? We don't know where he's going. Goober, where are you going? We don't know where you're going.
Well, I'm going to go to the Gap store. You know, that cool store in the mall. I'm going to go to the Gap store.
I've been there before. So what, are you going to get some new pants or something?
No, I'm not going to get new pants. I'm going to go over there because my friend told me I need to go to the Gap to stand in the Gap for a new friend that he met.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I don't think he meant for you to go to the Gap store to intercede. Do you know what intercede means?
No, but he told me to go to the Gap store and we're going to stand and intercede. So I'm going to stand there, I guess. I don't know what intercede means.
No, so wait a minute. He said to intercede means to stand in the gap. That's what intercession means. When you pray the prayer of intercession, you're standing in the gap between God and someone else.
Really?
The person you're praying for. Yes, really.
So, I don't think I understand. I'm going to stand in a gap and...
Yes, let me explain. So,
intercede.
Exactly. So, Goober, when you are interceding and praying for someone in the spirit, you don't know what they need, and they're not in a relationship with God, but you are by the Holy Spirit. You're able to go to God and bring their name to the Lord in prayer and intercede for God to intervene in their life.
Well, I know about praying in the spirit. You know, that's called praying in the tongues. But I don't know. What if I don't know their name? How can I pray for them?
Well, you can pray in the Spirit because the Spirit knows what is needed for them to get saved.
Wow, that sounds real exciting. Just think, the power of God, I can speak that power of God when I pray in the tongue for someone I don't even know.
Exactly.
That's pretty powerful and exciting too.
Exactly, Goober. You got it. Now, you're not going to the store now, are you?
No, all this talk about standing kind of makes me tired. You know, I think I need to go home and sit for a while. Can I sit in the gap?
Yeah, you could sit and pray and intercede.
All right,
yeah,
well, praise
exactly.
The Lord.
Exactly.
Thank you.
All right, everybody say bye, Goober. Wow. So the Gap store is not the place of intercession. You know, when we pray in the Spirit, God knows what is needed. Now I'm going to have everybody to sit up straight. Everybody sit up straight and stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. All right. Let's see who can stand up the quickest, the boys or the girls. All right. Everybody have a seat. And when I say on your feet, actually, let's do it this side versus that side. I want to see who can do it faster. When I say on your feet, you got to jump to your feet as fast as you can. Ready? On your feet. Wow, that was pretty fast. All right, have a seat. Let's see about this side over here. Let's see. On your feet. Wow, that was pretty much a tie. That was pretty good. I think you can do faster, though. Let's see. I didn't say on your feet. All right, have a seat. Are you ready? I got somebody over here. Can you sit up, buddy? Yeah. All right, ready? Hold on. Gotta stay seated. On your feet. Oh, my goodness. Wow, I had somebody sleeping over there. All right, let's see about this side. I think you're going to win. On your feet. Well, I don't know. Still kind of tired over there. I think y'all can do better. You think you can do better?
Yeah.
All right, ready? On your feet. Well, that was much better. He lost his balance. Let's see about you guys. Ready? On your feet. All right, somebody got a little jump start over there. All right, have a seat. Very good. All right, you guys are paying attention now, I see. Excellent. So why do we need to intercede for other people? Does anybody know? Why do we need to intercede? Why do we need to pray for other people? Why? So what? Yeah, but that's not the most reason. Like, that's not the greatest reason. Because we want everybody to have a good day. But what's a greater purpose? What's a greater reason than just having a good day? I mean, is that the best we can have in life is just a good day? Or does God have a greater plan, a bigger purpose for us? Why do we need to intercede for other people? Why? Why? So they can know about God and have a relationship with God. Exactly. So the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 4:4 that the devil has blinded the minds of unsaved people. Blinded the minds. Now, how many of you have ever seen anybody that wears like a sleep patch? That's kind of what they call them sometimes. They're like when you go to bed at night and you put a patch over your eyes so you don't have light bother. Maybe you sleep during the day and have to work at night. So you might wear something that covers your eyes. You ever seen that? All right. I used to wear that on the airplane a lot when I used to travel a lot. And I would sleep on the plane on really long flights, like 8, 9, 10-hour flights. I would sleep. To try and sleep on the plane, I would put an eye patch over my eyes, right? Eye patch, sleep patch, eye patch, whatever. It would cover my eyes. So the light wouldn't be a distraction. It would let me sleep. Well, you know what? The Bible says in 2 Corinthians, I just read it to you, that the devil blinds the eyes of people. Their minds, actually. It says the devil blinds their minds of unsaved people. And we know that the devil is the god of this world, right? So we need to intercede and pray for those people that their eyes are open to see the love of God. So when we do things that reach and bless people, in our actions, or even when we say things that bless people. You know, you can say things that bless people. You can say things like, "Hi, how are you today? I hope you have a good day." You can hold the door. That's doing something. You can hold the door and bless somebody by holding the door. You can help somebody carry something that's heavy, right? Those are ways that we can bless and help people. And when they see that you help them, but other people aren't helping them, then their eyes can be opened. But you know what? When you intercede and pray for them before, wow, that adds even more power to the situation. Why do we need power? Well, when we have Jesus in our heart, we have power. Everybody sit up straight. We have power so that we can be a witness to other people. When we pray in the Spirit, then we can intercede. Everybody say intercede. Intercede, all right? Intercede means to stand in the gap, not the Gap store like Mr. Goober was thinking, but intercede means to stand in the gap for someone else, all right? So why do we need to intercede for other people? Well, I tell you what, there's a lot of people, James, if you can get that video ready, there's a lot of people in the world that are blinded and they're running into things. They're not gonna fulfill God's plan for their life because they can't see what God's plan is. So we're gonna show you this little video about this really ridiculous race that I saw of these people that are, quite honestly, blinded. Let's take a look. Now, they have these helmets on, but they have blindfolds on. They can't see.
This is going to be great.
Go, 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 go. Very good.
There they go. When they run into a wall. That's fantastic. Look at that track.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to finish running 2 more meters. And you're there.
All right, you can stop it. Now, what happened to the one poor guy, that guy right there? What happened to him? He ran into the pole. Now, it's not easy to see where you're going if you're what? Blinded, right? So many people, God has a plan. Actually, he has a plan for all of your lives. He has a great plan for your life. But if you're blinded to what that plan is, you're going to run into the pole. You're not going to cross the line, the finish line that he has for you. How many of you want to do what God has for you? Yeah, me too. Excellent. All right, hands down. But you know what? If you don't pray and talk to God about what is that plan that you have for me, you could just run right into the pole with your life, right? Your life could end early. I mean, there's terrible things that could happen without seeking the Lord and inviting the Lord into your life to light your path and to show you what decisions to make. All right, everybody sitting up straight. And so we want to keep the blinders off. And one way we can do that is to intercede for the people around us that we know and that we love, right? Even the people, even our enemies. Do you know you can intercede for people you don't like? You can. You can pray for people you don't even like. In fact, it's a good idea to pray for people that you don't like. Exactly. We can pray for them. We don't even know what their needs are, but God does. You know, God likes everybody. He shines his grace on the just, that means the good, and the unjust and the bad. He gives everybody the opportunity to make a good decision and come to the knowledge and to know Christ. So everybody say this with me. Say, I will intercede for other people so that they will have eyes to see and ears to hear what the Lord is saying to them. So we can intercede for them. All right. Now, we are going to play a game, and I need two people If I could have my two workers on this side and this side to pick one person. Now, you have to qualify for this. All right. You have to be hungry and you have to like oranges, not be allergic to oranges. Okay. So if you could workers find those two people and bring them, have them come up to the stage. And Miss Kathy, if you could help me, I have plates over there. Could you bring me those plates? We're going to have a race. Race, 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 race. We're going to have an orange eating contest. All right. So I hope you're hungry. Miss Kathy, thank you for that. All right. Can you hold on just a second? I need to put my mask on for this because I got people everywhere. Okay. All right. All right. All right. All right. All right. There you go. You can take one. There you go. And take two napkins because it might get messy. Take another one. There you go. Okay. There you go. That's yours. I didn't touch it. It's all clean. They're washed up. All right. Now, what we're going to do is hands behind your back. I'm going to stand back here. You can take your masks off because you're not within close proximity and you can't eat that through your mask, right? All right. So you can put that on the table or in your pocket or wherever. But what we're going to do is race to eat the orange. Who's going to win? This side? Not sure. All right. How about this side? Anybody? Oh, we got a little more hope on this side. All right. I don't know. She doesn't look too hungry, but you look pretty hungry. Are you hungry? I thought so. Are you hungry? Maybe. Not sure. Undecided. All right. So what do we have to do if we're going to eat this orange first? Anybody? What do we have to do? Yes, sir. Open it. All right. So just a little tip. There's no seeds. The package says there's no seeds. So you don't have to worry about seeds. All right. I don't suggest that you eat the skin or the peeling. All right. So you got to have to peel it. All right. So I hope you have sharp nails. I did not bring a knife for you. You're going to have to tear into it. It's a race. So on your mark, get set. Oh, wait. So you have to eat the whole thing, but not the peeling. All right, so you have to open it up and eat what's on the inside. All right, on your mark, get set, go. All right. Wow, she's done this before, and she is almost finished peeling. She's not even looking. She is like, I got this. Wow, you're doing great. I'm impressed. Very good. Very good. Now she's laughing. You can't see her face, but she is laughing. Oh, she's got one down. And she's actually now not sure why she's even up here. She can't believe she's doing this. Oh, yeah, it's good. Is it good? I hope it's good. Okay. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, Miss Hungry over here, she has just put two in her mouth, going for three. She's picking up the pace. She's trying to catch up. All right, there she goes, four down. And now not so sure over here, is chewing as fast as she can. Very good. You all are impressed. I'm impressed. Y'all are doing good. Wow. All right, I have a prize for the winner. Oh, she just squirted juice across the floor. It's going to be all right. It smells wonderful up here. It's so aromatic. It's like a little citrus farm. Okay. All right. Wow, she's just shoving it all in there. She wants to win. Okay, was that your last piece? Oh, you got a whole handful. You're not even halfway done. Well, all right, she's got... okay, all right, here we go. She is, they're just staring. It's a stare down up here. They're staring. Oh, she is cleaning her hands and wiping her mouth. And I think we have to finish chewing. All right. She's chewing, chewing. She's chewing, chewing, chewing. No, don't throw up. Okay. Chew. You got to chew and swallow. You got to chew and swallow. And she's about to spit into her mask, but I think she's going to be all right. All right. You're doing great. All right, you got two pieces left, it looks like. All right, and she has swallowed the whole thing. Excellent. We got a winner over here. Good job. Woohoo! All right. Actually, I'm going to give you both prizes. In the bucket over here, the bowl, there's bubble gum over there. You can take a prize home with you and then go wash your hands. Please go wash your hands in the bathroom over on this side. All right. Good job. Now, class, what you see here on the plate, I want to look at these plates because look, what is this right here? This is the orange peel. Now, what was on the inside? Good job, girls. What was on the inside of the orange peel? Raise your hand. What was on the inside? What? The orange, not a watermelon. It was an orange. Exactly. Now, I'm going to take this off so you can hear me. So on the inside of the orange peel was the orange. Was it good? Let's see. Those that ate it just left the room. It smelled good. Let's all assume that it was good fruit. Everybody say good fruit. Good fruit. All right. Now, our friend here that we've been praying for has a plan and a purpose for her life that has good fruit in it. You know, when somebody's following God, they're going to have good fruit in their life. Y'all know what it means to have good fruit in your life? That means you're going to be fruitful. You're going to be productive. You're going to have good things, good results in your life, right? Y'all see what I mean? So this person we've been praying for, she's going to have good fruit. But there's something that has to happen first. Before the person can have good fruit in her life and we can see the good fruit, we have to do what? Nope. Before you can get to the fruit, you got to get this. You got to get the blinders off. You can't see the inside, what's on the inside of someone until this comes off. So what do we learn today about intercessory prayer? We can intercede by praying for someone. And when we pray for someone in the Spirit, we are going to stand in the gap. Everybody stand up on your feet. Everybody stand up. You're standing in the gap. And let's do this. Let's do this together. Let's pretend that God is right here and the person is right here. Now, go ahead and hold your hands out like this. All right. Now, take God's hand with one hand. And take the other person's hand with the other hand. Where are you? In the middle, right? You are standing in the gap between who? God and the person you're praying for. You see that? You're standing in the middle. You're standing in the gap. Because this person doesn't know God, but you're in by the Spirit, you're introducing them to God. Lord, I pray for... What can we give her a name? We got to give her a name. What can we name her? Anna. Okay, Lord, we need to pray for Anna. So we intercede for Anna. We're standing in the gap for Anna, between Anna and God. Everybody say, I'm standing in the gap.
I'm standing in the gap.
All right, so when we do that, we're praying, we're interceding for them so that their eyes and ears can see and hear what God is saying to them, because the Holy Spirit, the Bible says the Holy Spirit, everybody still standing? All right, we're standing in the gap. Everybody standing up. The Bible says the Holy Spirit draws men, draws, not like drawing with a crown, but drawing means to pull in close. So the Holy God is drawing people. He's pulling them in by the Holy Spirit. That happens by the Holy Spirit. It's not a matter of function that people come to Christ. It's by the Holy Spirit. When I say function, that means you don't just automatically come to Jesus when you're 13 or when you're 12. Like, okay, on your 12th birthday, everybody gets saved. That's automatic. That's not how it works, right? That is not how it works. We come to Christ by the Spirit, by the Holy Spirit. He draws people to know Christ. All right, you can be seated. All right, good job, everybody. Good job, everybody. Amen. All right, let's do a quick review of today's lesson. So we have some review questions on the board, and we're going to see who is paying attention. So what does intercede mean? A, B, C, or D? All right, I've got you. Yes, sir. What? A. He says A is the answer. Intercede, he says, means to A, stand in the gap. He says it doesn't mean to stand on the table. It doesn't mean to eat a lot of Twinkies, and it doesn't mean the same as the prayer of faith. All right, so is A correct? How many of you say A is correct? All right, Mr. Paul says A is correct. It must be correct. All right, let's give him a big hand. Yeah. All right, next question. The prayer of intercession is standing in the gap for blank. Standing in the gap for blank. All right, in the back right here. Yes, ma'am. Yes, A, B, C, or D? Or C. Okay, she says C. She says it's not standing in the gap for my lunch money. It's not my big toe to be healed. It is C for someone else. All right, that's a good answer. We'll give it to you. C is the right answer. All right, amen. Next question. How come lost people don't get saved? They're lost. How come they don't get saved? All right, let's see over here. Yes, sir, right here in the second row with your hand up. Yes, sir. A, B, C, or D? How come lost people don't get saved? Did you say D or B? D? Okay. He says D, the devil has blinded their minds. So he says it's not A, that they like to sin. It's not B, they want to go to hell. It's not C, they don't like church. He said D, the devil has blinded their minds. And that is correct.
Amen.
That's correct. Good job. All right, I might not be the last question, but next question. Who will help us intercede? Who will help us intercede? All right, let's see. Right here in the black shirt. Yes. Did you say D? B. Okay, B. All right, so it's not the Pope. She says it's B, the Holy Spirit. She says it's not C, Superman, or D, lost people. So, yes, B is correct.
Yay!
The Holy Spirit helps us intercede. All right, next question. All right, last question here. What should I do before witnessing to my friends? So before I go and witness and tell them about the Lord, what should I do? Right here. Yes, sir. All right, he says, did you say D? All right, D. All right, he says intercede for them. He says it's not A, take a shower.
All right. Although it's a good idea.
Might be a good idea to be clean. All right, not smelly. All right, B, brush my teeth. Well, it might be a good idea to do that too. But okay, C, give them bubble gum. Or D, intercede for them. The best answer is D, intercede for them. Very good. Very good. All right. All right. Now we got Anna up here who we need to intercede for. So let's just review. You might have some questions. So I want to ask, do you have any questions about the prayer of intercession? Anybody? Raise your hand quickly. Quickly. Anybody have any questions? No questions. All right. So now everybody, let's think about someone that we can intercede for. You got a question? All right. What you got? Communion. All right. No, we received communion. I think it was last week we had communion. So we do communion. We receive communion once a month. All right. So if you missed it last week, keep coming back and you can receive it with us. Mr. Paul.
Mr. Scott, who is trying to keep us from receiving from God?
The devil.
Well, I was hoping kid might.
Oh, well, you asked, you said Mr. Scott. Like you had a question.
Yes, that's
okay.
True.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I interrupted your thought.
Oh.
All right. Yep.
But that's correct.
Yes.
He's trying to keep everybody from getting what God has for them. He doesn't want them. He's jealous. He's going around trying to steal everything from people so they can't receive from God, which is their salvation.
Exactly.
He'd go to heaven.
So you all probably have family. You might have friends. They don't know who Jesus is, but you can intercede just like we interceded for Anna. You can stand in the gap and pray for them. not just their salvation, but you can intercede for them to get a new job if they need a job. You can intercede and pray for their, what else? Healing, maybe they need healing. What else? What else would someone might need? Whatever their need is. If you know they have a need, you can pray for their need. All right? Yeah.
Can I share a quick testimony?
Sure. Oh, I love testimonies.
A long time ago, I was starting a job at a new company. You know, I was brand new, didn't know anybody. And the guy that I had to work with was real rough. He had like a biker chains, and he was just really, I don't know what the word to use, but he wasn't saved. You know, he had just really kind of like...
Not friendly.
Not friendly, yeah. Nothing like that. And so he left the company within a couple of days, because I guess I found out that I was going to replace him. But you know what? The Holy Spirit told me to pray for that guy. He looked like a, you know, he looked real kind of like wanting to do bad things to people. He looked like somebody who didn't know about Jesus. So I didn't even really know him, but the Lord told me, the Holy Spirit told me to pray for this guy. So I started praying for him, and I kept praying in the Spirit.
Wow.
This went on for a long, long time, probably almost a year or more. And I just kept praying in the Spirit for this guy. And guess what happened one Sunday? We had a new sanctuary built. One Sunday, who do you think I saw walking down the aisle to accept Jesus in their life?
Wow.
It was that man.
Amen.
That man, the Holy Spirit had prayed. We've been praying in his tongue for this young man. And the devil was trying to keep him from getting saved. But the Holy Spirit came through, and he came down the aisle and gave his life to the Lord. And he had two kids, and they got saved.
Wow.
And they actually started his kids started being friends with my kids.
So, amen.
And one more time, this is a true story. There used to be a really bad sheriff of a town. He was a bully, and he picked on people. He beat up on the people. That he was the sheriff, so they couldn't really do much about it because he was like the law, but he was doing evil things to people. The whole town was afraid of him because he was so evil and did such mean things. Well, this one little, really old lady, she didn't know him, but she said, the Holy Spirit told her, I'm gonna pray for him. She didn't know this guy, but I mean, he was evil. He did evil, not he was, but he did evil things.
Yeah, yeah.
So this really old lady doesn't even know this guy, but she can see what he was doing to these people. So she started praying in the Spirit for this young man, this bully, this terrible sheriff. And she kept praying for him, kept praying for him, kept praying for him. And just like when I was praying for that young man, one day when she was at church, that sheriff came down the aisles at church, gave his life to the Lord, and became saved, and started loving people, and started to be a really good person for other people.
Amen.
Amen. And it works. It really works.
That's a great testimony. And you know what? It reminds me, there's a Bible story in the Old Testament in Genesis where Abraham interceded for two towns, Sodom and Gomorrah. Have anybody ever heard of Abraham who prayed and asked the Lord to save those that were in the town? Has anybody ever heard of Sodom and Gomorrah? Well, there was a man and his family named Lot. And Abraham prayed, and really because of his intercession, because he prayed to the Lord, Lot and his family were saved. They were spared from the destruction that came on Sodom and Gomorrah. And so just like Mr. Paul gave this testimony of interceding, and it didn't happen overnight. He prayed for a long time for someone, and they, guess what? They came to Christ. They came and got saved. And so when we pray for an intercession, we need to continue to thank the Lord, intercede, pray in the Spirit continually. Everybody say continually. Y'all know what continually means, right? That means don't give up. Everybody say over and over. All right, now it doesn't mean that we're going to continue to pray the same thing. When we pray and intercede, first of all, when we intercede, we pray in the Spirit, in the Holy Spirit. We pray in tongues, right? Then we can pray in our what we call the understanding. You pray in your known language that you speak. You can pray and ask the Lord for what you know, and then you thank the Lord. And so when you go back continually to the Lord, you're praying in the Spirit, in the Holy Spirit, and you're thanking the Lord. You're not having a vain repetition, as the New Testament calls it, all right? So you're thanking the Lord. Thank you, Lord, that Anna is born again. Thank you, Lord, that she has ears to hear what the Spirit has to say. All right, everybody stand to your feet. Everybody stand up. All right, now, Miss Kathy, we were given the announcements tonight, and she said to be sure and to tell you about the water baptism. All right, how many of you in the room have been baptized in water? Baptized in water. We got a few of you. All right, some of you. All right, you can have a seat. You can have a seat. All right, so what is water baptism? Well, baptize means, does anybody know what baptize means? What does baptize mean? What? Baptize. What does it mean, baptize? The word baptize. What does it mean? What? No. What does it mean? No. Baptize. 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 It's a real simple meaning. What does it mean? No. It means to go under, to submerge. All right. So if Anna was going to get baptized, she would go under into something. What are some things we could baptize Anna into? We could baptize her into what? Jello? Could we put her in Jello? We could put her in what? What else could we put her in? What? Coke, soda. All right, we could baptize her in soda. What else? Water. We could soak her and put her in, submerge in water. You know, if I had a bowl, like a clear bowl. Miss Kathy, could you grab that clear bowl? There's one. There's extra bowls right there on the end. Right here, Miss Kathy, on the end of the stage. Could you bring me one of those bowls? Yeah. This is a very good demonstration of baptism. Baptize. All right. Thank you so much. So Anna here needs to get baptized, but what needs to, she needs to be, there's different types of baptism. So there's the baptism into Christ. That means submerged and being brought into salvation, into knowing Jesus as your Lord and Savior. That's the baptism of salvation. Everybody say it with me. Say baptism of salvation. So that means it's kind of a figure of speech, right? It's a word picture. These are different ways that you would say it, all right? It's baptized unto salvation. So you are brought into, submerged into a relationship. That's kind of cool. You could look at it that way. Brought into a relationship. So when I got to know Mr. Paul in the back, I was brought into a relationship with him. And over time, we have a very close relationship. We're pretty close. We almost every week, we're talking on the phone or we're texting each other. So you could say that I am submerged into a relationship with Mr. Paul because we've been pretty close now for 15, 20 years. Long, long, long time. All right. So Mr. Paul actually lives down the street from me. We're almost neighbors. I mean, you know, a few neighborhoods away. And so we know each other pretty well. He knows my family and prays for them. And I know his family and I pray for him. So does it sound like I'm pretty close to him? Yeah, you might have people like that in your life. So you are, you could say you are in relationship with them. You have submerged into their family, into their relationship, right? All right, so how about that? So if you're saved, you're born again. Raise your hand if you have Jesus in your heart, you have a relationship with God through the Holy Spirit. Very good. Look at all those hands. Awesome, awesome. All right, hands down. Then you are already baptized unto salvation. Pretty cool. Now, that's the first thing that needs to happen. Another baptism we experienced last week. If you were in the class last week, then you experienced the baptism unto the Holy Spirit. So that's when you are submerged in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit really fills you up and takes over how you pray, giving you a prayer language, right? That's being submerged, being filled with the Holy Spirit, coming under the power of the Holy Spirit, giving you a new language. All right, how many of you received that last week? Raise your hand if you prayed in the Spirit, maybe for the first time last week. Raise your hand. You received. All right, good. I see your hands. There was seven children in the room that I counted that received the baptism of the Holy Spirit last week. All right, so a couple of you are in the room today. That's excellent. Others might be joining us online. If you want to go back, it's posted on the website. You can go back and watch the lesson on the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Actually, the prayer of the Holy Spirit, we called it last week, but it's also the baptism. That's a second baptism, the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And that's for anybody who knows Jesus. You have a relationship with Jesus, you're born again, you can receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit and be able to pray in this language that we've been talking about. It's a language between you and God the Father. All right, and then there is water baptism. So water baptism is if Anna gets saved, which we're praying for Anna, right? Let's say Anna gets saved today because we're going to pray the prayer of salvation today. So Anna gets saved. After we pray the prayer, Anna wants to be water baptized. Why does Anna want to be water baptized? Does anybody know? Why? No. So water baptism is not about being clean, not to wash your face in the water. It's not about that. Water baptism is really for everybody else that's around you. So all your friends and family will know that, guess what happened? Anna is born again. So it's really to testify and to tell others that Jesus has washed away your sin. So let's say Anna, she's now accepted Christ into her life, and she's gonna do what? We said baptize means to submerge, right? So she is gonna submerge, means to go all the way under, getting all the way wet, and then she's gonna come back out. Now, who do we know that laid down his life for us? Who? What's his name? God the Son is Jesus, right? So Jesus laid down his life. And then what happened after 3 days? What? Adam. He rose from the dead. That's right. He was resurrected is another way to say that. Resurrected. He rose back up. And so when we are water baptized, it's a symbol. It's a word picture of what's happened on the inside of us. So when we ask Jesus to come into our life, then we identify with Jesus because he took our sin on the cross. He died for us. He was laid down in the tomb, and he was what? Resurrected. He came up out of the tomb alive. Pretty cool, huh? Well, when we are water baptized, we are demonstrating. It's a picture of what's happened on the inside of us. Because we were once blinded by the enemy. We had our blinders on. We couldn't see. The Bible actually says that our spirit was dead. But when we receive Christ, it's made what? Alive. And so it's a picture. When we come up out of the water, it's a picture of what's happened on the inside of us. Hey, when we ask Jesus into our life, we actually our spirit becomes alive, alive. So, you know what? There might be somebody in the room today, and you say, I want some of that. I want to be baptized unto Jesus. I want to have that relationship with Him because things in my life aren't going too well. I want to have an eternal life in heaven with all of you guys. So there might be somebody in the room. I'm going to ask everybody to stand to your feet with me. We're going to pray this prayer. I'm going to invite those of you that are joining us on the internet, online. If you don't know Christ by being baptized unto salvation, if you haven't invited Him into your life and submerged your life into His plan that He has for you, you can join us because that's what we're going to do right now. So everybody standing still? All right, everybody, let's close our eyes. And if you say, hey, that's me, I want to ask Jesus to come into my life. I've never done that before. Raise your hand. We want to pray with you. All right, I see your hand. Anybody else? All right, let's pray this with me. Say this, say, Father God, I invite Jesus to come into my life. I give you my life. And I make you my Lord and Savior. I ask you to forgive me of all of my sins, and I will live for you from this day forward in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. All right, congratulations, those of you too that raised your hand to pray the prayer with us. That is excellent. And so that's what this flyer is about, is water baptized. So parents that are coming in, we have a water baptism flyer. All your children have this, and it's coming up next Sunday, so they are invited to participate. Let's see. Miss Kathy, can you come check stickers here? Excellent.